Welcome back to Athletic Everyday, day number 57. Got a jump day coming at you right now, and this one went really, really well, guys. I'm super pleased with how I performed in this workout, and it was a little bit up and down during the workout, actually. I mean, throughout the warm-up, it's always the same kind of like emotional feel, just building up gradually, trying to increase the intensity, raise, activate, mobilize, and potentiate all the muscles in my body so that I'm ready to jump. And I probably got to about a third of the way through my jumping, and I missed a few dunks that I knew I could make, which is offer on 9'3". I've been making that quite consistently recently, and I missed it probably three or four times in a row, and I was just like, man, I'm so pissed off. I got really, really angry, and it just goes to show how much of, especially one like maximal effort, one single exertion of force and power, attempts like jumping, sprinting, throwing, anything like that. It's so mental. The mental side of it is very, very big, and it's a very, very large component of how you perform. And there's obviously a very scientific reason for that. It's because when you have the correct neural drive, when you can activate and fire more of your motor neurons, then a larger proportion of your muscle fibers are going to contract, therefore more force in less time. So you're going to have a much larger output, whether that's jumping higher, throwing longer, or sprinting faster. So I think that the mental side of athletic performance is very, very crucial. So don't just point it off as, oh, that's airy-fairy nonsense. It really can have a genuinely big effect on performance, and you'll see later on as I go through the jumping workout, my performance actually improves when I start to, maybe it was just changing my self-talk, trying to speak more positively, or just getting out of my head and just starting to do the attempts. I remember when I used to do a lot of jumping attempts, kind of like in the past, let's say a year and a half ago, maybe even a year ago, I would get so in my head about not jumping as high as I could, to the point where I would literally just stop jumping and focus on the anger and resentment I had from not being able to jump as high as I wanted to. And then that would just make the workout feel like it was a loss. I'd feel like I'd failed, and I feel like I wouldn't have performed my best. But if you just overcome that sort of flinching response, because right before you do a maximal effort exertion, whether that's a jump, whether that's a max clean and jerk, a max snatch, there's that moment where you, right before you're about to exert all of the possible force you can in a fraction of a second, you have that kind of like, am I going to do it now, or am I going to wait another second and do it now? You have that sort of moment where you almost want to hesitate, and being able to actually not hesitate and continue and just do it, It's very, very difficult, because you think like, am I going to be able to exert the most amount of force right now, or should I pause and wait again? And it's only on the most difficult attempts. When you're doing it on a low rim, you can sort of get away with not jumping your highest. But when you get onto the higher rims and the higher attempts, it feels like there's a lot more at stake conceptually. But again, if you're conceptualizing, you're probably thinking too much and you're not acting. And that is something that I tried to do my best in this workout. So when the rim heights got higher and higher, I try to be a little bit less in my head and just try my best on the attempt. If I make it, that's great. If I don't, then I can live with that, rather than just hesitating and being in that kind of that sort of limbo when you're almost about to make it, you're about to jump, and then you don't quite give it your full maximum effort. And that's pretty much what happened today. So I did do some things that I haven't done before today. Most notably, I hit an off vert 9'9" with a volleyball. I've never done that before, so that shows some progress in my vertical jump. It does mean I am jumping higher than I have done in the past, because I've never been able to do an off 9'9" dunk with the volleyball. Granted, jumping with a ball that you can palm versus jumping with a ball that you can't are two completely different things. Nonetheless, that is a win for me, and I'm really pleased with it. And here are those attempts now. Then I did some 2 foot, 9'6" two-handers, trying to get, just as many as I can. And then today I also got a right-left plant two-hander on 9'6", which again is a first for me. Super pleased with that one, as you saw there. Then I got really close. I got excited to try and do my 9'6" offer again. Tried it a couple more times, didn't quite get it, but I'm really, really close. I'm going to get that soon. And You know when you've already done something, you feel like you've already succeeded in the workout and you want to just push it a little bit more? Even if you don't make it on that next attempt, you already feel good because you've done something that you've already succeeded at. So it feels good. Then after I finished my jumps for the day, I decided that I would go off script a little bit and I would do some very, very shallow angle, kind of like box quarter squats, trying to mimic and replicate the angle of knee flexion that I am when I'm jumping maximally. And I actually managed to go up to 190 with these. I probably could have gone like beyond 200, but my bar doesn't actually have enough space to use these plates. I do have some thinner plates, but they're tucked away in the garage somewhere and I couldn't be asked to get them out. But yeah, these felt good. To be honest, I think I probably could have gone a touch lower with the box, but that was the lowest I could probably have done with the equipment I have in my garage. I'd have to make something if I wanted to get it to be the perfect height, but these felt snappy, they felt explosive. You can see the bar popping at the top, and yeah, they felt good. I think I need to start incorporating more stuff like this, like more joint angle specific type things. If you actually look at some of my jumps, most of the time I'm probably in a slightly deeper range of knee flexion because I am a power jumper. I'm definitely not a speed two-footed jumper. Obviously, difference between power and speed being the joint angle and the amount of ground contact time. So yeah, definitely you'll see me incorporating more of these box squats. Again, super duper high intensity, but nice low volume. I think I did 3 sets of 3 today. Then I finished up with some single-legged pistol squats or weighted pistol squats or zombie pistol squats. I'm not sure what I'd call this variation. Program said not to go below parallel, and I'm not sure why, but I felt like I wanted to get a full range of motion movement out of this. And I really must say I've missed doing pistol squats. I haven't done them in a long time. And doing them just with the bar like this, it challenges your balance, it challenges your stability and your coordination. And what I like about hitting the bottom of the pistol squat is I can really feel like a coordination between the contraction of my glute and my knee in that really, really deep range of hip and knee flexion. And I can feel like I'm almost like bouncing. I'm getting an even contribution of quads and glutes when I bounce out of the hole there like that. And I'm able to maintain a nice upright torso when I stand up like that because I'm having to hold that bar in that zombie front rack position. There's no sort of dipping forward, otherwise the bar is going to roll off your arms. So I quite like this variant, and also I'll be incorporating this once a week in this workout here. So every Friday I'll be doing this. But yeah, I'm really pleased with this workout, guys. I must say I'm really pleased with my performance. I'm super happy with how well I jumped. The warm-up went well. I think a part of that reason is because I had a shit ton of caffeine earlier on today. I went and met up with a friend and had probably a bit too much coffee with him in the morning. But nonetheless, I think that definitely energized me for this workout. I felt super duper hyped up. I felt snappy and explosive. So yeah, just looking forward to doing the same workout again next week and getting through this next stage of the program. So this is the first time doing this workout in this 5-week microcycle. So I've got 4 more of this workout to try and really increase my vertical and hopefully get that dunk on 10 feet soon. That first proper legit dunk on 10 feet. I finished up here with some one down, two up calf raises. One down, two up eccentric overload calf raises to really overload my gastroc and get as much volume in there as I could. I think going back to talking about dunking, the biggest barrier between me getting my first dunk on 10 feet and pretty much where I am right now is just the palming of the basketball. I think I can actually jump high enough to get my hand above the rim. So if I was able to do a lob, I had enough space and obviously the ideal type of floor to do that, I would be able to get it pretty soon, but I want to get it doing it off of like a full approach with the ball in my hands and, you know, doing it that way, the good old fashioned way. It might take me a bit longer, but it's going to be so worth it when I finally get that first dunk on 10 feet. It's going to feel really good. Yeah. All right, that's it for me, and I'll catch you guys in the next one.